Hello everyone, welcome to my course on image morphology. In this particular course we will learn about what do you mean by morphology and what are the different type of morphological operations that we can use. So image morphology is nothing but performing an operation on an image using a small restructuring element. A restructuring element could be a small rectangle which is usually of size 3 by 3, 3 rows and 3 matrix, 3 rows and three rows and 3 columns, but you could use a restructuring element of any arbitrary size. So what we do is, given an image, big image, which is of the size, which is of the any size, could be 600 by 600, 1000 by 800, 1900 by 1200 pixels, any size. What we do is, we divide this into 3 by 3 areas, right, and apply a specific operation. Basically slide this 3 by 3 small matrix above and perform the operations with each corresponding 3 by 3 area of the pixel, and slide that 3 by 3 matrix to the right and then to the bottom, and keep performing that operation until you get the desired result. Now the operation could be of different types. For example, if you perform an opening operation, you will remove those white dots in the image and the output image would be like this. So that is an example of an image morphological operation. There are different types of morphological operations, and there are combinations of the morphological operations that you can use to create even more interesting effect. So this is an effect of an opening operation. When you performed it, basically what it does is it removes something called a salt noise from the image, which are nothing but the white dots in the image. And this operation is performed by the combination of erosion followed by dilation. And you will study those operations in detail in the subsequent lectures. So this is an opening operation example. Then opposite of that is a closing operation, which is a dilation followed by an erosion. This operation is very useful for removing the paper noise, which are basically nothing but black dots in your image. When you perform this operation, all the black dots are removed, and you get a clean image. The next operation is the morphological gradient operation. This operation is very famous for creating an outline of an image. So let's say this is an image of a Taj Mahal. If you apply a morphological gradient on this, you will get an outline of that image very, very clearly. So this reminds me of a neon lights that you see basically on a lot of shops at night. So you can create that neon lighting effect using this morphological gradient operation. Then the next one is a white hat operation. This operation is used for highlighting the white object on the dark backgrounds. So in this particular case, you see the entire road sign is on the black. It's basically is on the light background, and this entire plate can be highlighted using the white hat operator, right? Then we can also see what is a black hat operator. The black hat operator is exactly opposite. It is used for highlighting the dark objects on the white background. So in this particular case, instead of highlighting the whole road sign, we can just highlight the letters on this road sign, which are nothing but a black appearing on a white background. So when you apply a black hat operator, you will see the only letters are highlighted and the rest of the stuff is turned dark. So in this course, we will study this operation in detail, and we will also see how can we use a Python and OpenCV, just a few lines of code, to perform this really powerful operations. And once you learn this, you will be able to apply this on scale. Since you will learn to apply this programmatically, you can apply this code on thousands or even millions of images, and you can get the output in a matter of few seconds. So scaling your code to process thousands and millions of images, that's the main advantage that you get by studying this course. To study this course, all you need is basically a Python. OpenCV also, if you don't have any background, that's perfectly fine. We will study very basic operations of OpenCV, and I will also teach you how to install all the required packages and get it up and running within a matter of few minutes. All right, let's get started.